the Savior today, but you have to trust Him as your Lord and Savior. You have to repent of your old life. You have to turn away from the things that are ungodly. Because if you don't turn away from the things that are ungodly, then you'll come under the judgment of God. It says, when the morning was come, all the chief priests and elders of the people took counsel against Jesus to put him to death. And when they bound him, they led him away and delivered him to Pontius Pilate, the governor. Matthew 27:1-2. They led him away. But why did they lead him away? They led him away because it was ordained of God that he would die for us. Jesus Christ, God bless you, bro. Jesus Christ, you need Christ the Savior. You need Christ the Lord. You need Christ in your life. You need Christ to be born again today. To be born again of the Holy Ghost. God commendeth his love to us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. God commendeth his love to us, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. But we are sinners. We're sinners, my friend. We've broken the commandments of God. We've broken those commandments, and we need redemption. We need forgiveness.
Hallelujah.
God bless you, God.
Hallelujah. God is good.
God loves you. Jesus loves you. The Lord is your advocate. He's your solicitor. He will one time again become your judge. Now, before you get that day, now I shall not live by bread alone. The gospel is free. Repent, and you and your house will be saved. The Lord is coming back again. He promised to come back, and He's coming back. He's the beginning and the end of everything. He's the creator. He's the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, the one that created you. We're not talking about religion here. We're not talking about politics. We're not talking about group. We're not talking about title. We are talking about the living God, Jesus Christ, the only living God. That every man believe that He's the Son of the living God. He died and resurrected for your sin. So when you come to Him, this is the hour for you. He's knocking at your door. Open your heart and accept Him humbly, and then you will be saved. No man can save you. No woman can save you. Your government cannot save you. Your politics cannot save you. Your money cannot save you. It's only the Savior. The one that saves is the one that can save you.